Hey, you guys, welcome back to Creole Kisses Diary TV, y'all. I'm coming back at you guys with some more hip-hop news, more drama. I'm sure you've all been seeing your girl Megan Thee Stallion in the headlines. She's been going back and forth with her label, 1501 Entertainment, owned by Carl Crawford. If you're not familiar, Carl Crawford is the owner of 1501 Entertainment. He's an ex-baseball player, and he's also known as the baby father of Evelyn Lozada, okay, from Basketball Wives. Yes. So, Megan Thee Stallion took to Instagram Live. She went on a rant, and she wanted everybody to know that she would not be releasing any music for the springtime, and it's not her doing. She stated that after Roc Nation looked over her contract, they told her, no, honey, something ain't right with this contract. So what she did was she went back to 1501. She let them know, can we go ahead and renegotiate this contract? And after she said that, she said everything went left. So now here we are today. Megan is suing 1501 and Carl Crawford for at least $1 million in damages. The lawsuit is claiming that the deal gave her 40% of her recording income, and that's before she pays everyone who works on her songs. In the claim, it also stated that the label has been purposely and deceptively vague in paying her out. So Megan immediately went to court. She filed a restraining order against 1501 Entertainment. The judge granted that temporary restraining order and also allow her to release new music by the end of this week. So at this point, Carl Crawford is feeling betrayed. He feels like Megan has been disloyal, and he's not happy about it, okay? Carl said he's just trying to get paid at this point. He is not giving up his rights to Roc Nation, and he even made some comments about Jay-Z. So, during the interview, they did ask him, have you talked to Jay-Z or anyone on that side? He said, no, because I don't respect this black power trying to help black people. We look up to this man, Jay-Z, as a person, as a black man. We all look up to him. This is how you meet him for the first time. This is your introduction to Jay-Z, him trying to take something from me. So, all that is fake to me. You ain't trying to help. You trying to help certain ninjas. So according to this, it looks like Carl is not happy with Jay-Z, okay? According to this comment, looks like he feels that Jay-Z is trying to steal Megan Thee Stallion. And it looks like Megan is trying to get out of her contract. But 1501, they not gonna let her go that easy. Oh, no, ma'am. They like, check this out. We put all this money into you. We got you going. We got you started. We not giving you up that easy. And you know Megan Thee Stallion big. And when Jay-Z saw that, he snatched Megan Thee Stallion up real quick. Okay? And now she's trying to get out that contract. We not stupid. We know what you're trying to do, Megan. And, you know, I mean, there's nothing wrong with wanting better. But you still gonna have to honor that contract, honey. You shouldn't have signed it. She's saying that she signed it at the age of 20. He's saying she's lying. She's 25 when she signed that contract, so she knew what was going on. So it's a lot of tit for tat, and it's just getting real ugly, you guys. It's going way too far. So Jay Prince from Houston, Texas, he is the CEO of Rap-A-Lot Records. He took to Instagram and said, breaking news alert. Houston, we have a problem, Megan. Along with Roc Nation employee Jen Tenjali, Grace Lyer decided to include my name in a lawsuit wrapped around lies and stupidity. We gonna get this blank straight. Now let's deal with the root of this issue. The root is a familiar one for me, coming from a successful independent record label's perspective. We as independent record labels make many sacrifices along with the artists. After we do all the hard work together with artists, it's a known fact that major record labels and established managers attempt to poach the fruits of our labor. One of the first things they do is criticize the deal that raised that artist from the dead. These record labels and managers don't want blank to do with these artists until the hard work, risk, sacrifices, and resources have been spent by the little guys. This is the same technique of the culture vultures. I didn't allow this to happen to me when New York and LA record labels attempted to take my artist, so they labeled me as malicious for fighting back. I didn't allow it then, and I blank sure ain't gonna allow it to happen to 1501 Records or any of the other independent record labels that I'm associated with. For the record, we have no problem with negotiating with Megan, but we do have a problem with dictators. I find it very interesting that Roc Nation would allow their employee to sign an affidavit and statement full of slanderous lies on my methods of doing business when we have partnered together on several occasions. I don't think Jay-Z is aware of this, but only time will tell. Megan, even though she signed an affidavit, talked down and lied in court documents on me. I understand how lawyers brainwash artists to milk them of funds and lawsuits that they know they can't win. Megan seems to be a perfect candidate for self-destruction. Any artist in the music industry will testify that a 40% profit share is a great deal, especially for an unestablished artist that till this day has never delivered an album. To end this, I give credit to where credit is due. Megan, along with her mother, who evidently could read, God rest her soul, negotiated a good deal. I extended my hand to meet with Megan, T. Ferris, and team personally for further negotiations. Unfortunately, it never happened, even though we're all in Houston, because she's being controlled by the very people who started this. The homie Carl was an angel in Megan's eyes when he was spending hundreds of thousands investing in her career. Now that he's helped her become a successful artist, she stopped paying him his percentage and views him as the devil. I'm glad money don't make me, I make money. So Jay Prince, he had his say. He spoke how he feels about the situation. And we just have to see how this all plays out, you guys. On another note, someone tried to involve Evelyn in the drama and posted on her page that her man is, her baby daddy is wilding out. And she said, go talk to his other baby mamas. Don't involve me in that crap. Okay? I don't blame you, Evelyn. Keep me out that drama. So how y'all think this is gonna play out? Do y'all think that eventually 1501 will lose Megan? Well, it sounds like they already lost her, but under contract they haven't as of yet. But what do you think? You think that they're gonna release her eventually? You think Jay-Z, Roc Nation is gonna pay them off so that they can have her fully? Let me know your thoughts, you guys. Megan, she said, facts are facts and the facts are public. I'm extremely pleased that 1501 and Carl Crawford were denied the request to dissolve the court order and try to stop my music from being released. I will proceed with the release of Sugar on Friday, March 6th. To be clear, I will stand up for myself and won't allow two men to bully me. I am no one's property. Y'all are choosing to highlight the issue of music splits. Talk about everything else. This has nothing to do with anyone else, including Jay-Z. Stop deflecting and trying to make this a publicity stunt. I want my rights. And the facts are, 1501 doesn't want to approve my budget to put out my project that the court is allowing me to release. 1501 tried to stop my release. I prevailed in court. 1501 tried to fight the decision today. The court denied 1501's request. Respect my deceased mother. She's not here. You don't know her. You weren't involved. Carl should speak for himself. All the facts are public record, available at the courthouse in Houston. So y'all heard it. Megan says she is standing up for herself. She don't, no one own her. She don't belong to nobody. And she's gonna do her. And that's that. So I'm gonna go ahead and end this. Hopefully this all turns out well for them, but as far as it's going, it's not looking good, you guys. Y'all have a good night. Leave your thoughts. Don't forget to subscribe, share the video, like, and I will talk to y'all later. Love you guys. Bye.
You already know what it is. All money in, no money out. Creo Kisses, man.
Shout out to Creo Kisses. Diary. Yeah.